life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. Life cycle of Plasmodium vivax. Okay. Sir, here if you take Plasmodium vivax, which is also a protozoan parasite, let us write classification here. Let us write classification. Okay. Sir, phylum protozoa. What is the phylum? Protozoa. Next, if you take subphylum, if you take subphylum, this is epicomplexa. What is this? Epicomplexa. Okay. So here, generally class Telosporia. What is the class? Telosporia. So genus, you know, Plasmodium. Genus Plasmodium. Species vivax. Species is nothing but vivax. Okay, so this is the classification of Plasmodium vivax. Sir, Plasmodium vivax, it is a common protozoan parasite which causes malaria disease. Which causes malaria disease. Okay, sir, this is digenetic parasite. This is digenetic parasite. So why we are calling it as digenetic parasite? Sir, here as it lives in two hosts. So as it lives in two hosts, it is called as digenetic parasite. So if it completes life cycle in two para hosts, then it is said to be digenetic parasite. So di means two, genetic means host. So means in the digenetic parasite, primary host. What primary host is? Female Anopheles mosquito, sir. Female Anopheles mosquito. Okay, so next, secondary host, if you see, if you look at the secondary host is the human being. Secondary host is the human being. Okay. So man is the secondary host. I already discussed in the beginning of the chapter. So what is primary host? What is secondary host? If parasite undergoes sexual development, that is called as primary host. If parasite undergoes asexual life cycle, that is called as secondary host. And this is cytozoic parasite. What is this? Cytozoic parasite. Cytozoic parasite means what? It lives inside the host cells. Lives inside the host cells, especially RBC of man, as well as liver cells of man. Liver cells of man. So this is cytozoic parasite, digenetic parasite, and it is cosmopolitan. It is actually distributed throughout the many countries. Okay, it causes malaria disease. Okay, now next, it is transmitted by female Anopheles mosquito, and infective stage is sporozoite. What is the infective stage? Sporozoite. So this is infective stage. Okay, now next, infection is by the inoculation. How infection takes place? Especially by the inoculation. So inoculation causes infection. Okay, now so inoculation of mosquito bite causes transmission of malaria disease. Sir, if you take the Plasmodium genera, there are four species. How many species are there? Four species are there. Okay, let's see them. One is Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax, which causes benign tertian malaria. Benign tertian malaria. Okay, na? Next thing is Plasmodium falciparum. Plasmodium falciparum, this is causes malignant tertian malaria. Okay, na? So here malignant tertian malaria. Third one is Plasmodium bovale. This is called as mild tertian malaria. Mild tertian malaria. So this is called as mild tertian malaria. Next fourth one is Plasmodium malariae. Plasmodium malariae, this is called causes quartan malaria. Quartan malaria. So these are the four species of Plasmodium genus which causes different types of malaria fever. So Plasmodium vivax causes benign tertian malaria. Plasmodium falciparum causes malignant tertian malaria. Plasmodium ovale causes mild tertian malaria. And Plasmodium malariae causes quartan malaria. Okay, now next, let us see history of malaria. So history of malaria. Sir, if you take the history of the malaria, generally the malaria was thought to be caused by the bad air. So that is why they have given a name, malaria. So mala means bad, area means air. So here they thought that malaria is caused due to the bad air. Malaria is caused due to the bad air. So that is why they kept an Italy word. Malaria is which word? Italy word, which gives you bad air meaning. Okay, now for the first time that malaria parasite Plasmodium vivax was identified in the human being. Okay, so here generally if you take the history of malaria, sir, if you take a Scottish military doctor, for example, if you take Sir Patrick Monson is there. Sir Patrick Monson, he is a Scottish doctor. He is a Scottish doctor. While he is working on the filariasis, he identified that. So malaria is caused by the female Anopheles mosquito. Female Anopheles mosquito. For the first time, the malaria parasite was identified by the Charles Laveran scientist. Charles Laveran scientist is a French military doctor. So Charles Laveran is a French military doctor. First time parasite was identified by the Charles Laveran. Later, that Plasmodium vivax is transferred by the female Anopheles mosquito. That was identified by the Patrick Monson. Later, if you see Sir Ronald Ross. Who is the scientist? Sir Ronald Ross. Actually, he is a British military doctor. While he is working. In the fever hospital of Andhra Pradesh. So, while he was working in the fever hospital Andhra Pradesh, he identified the, oocysts. He identified the oocyst on the crop wall of the mosquito. So he identified what? Oocysts on the wall of the crop. So on the wall of the crop, he identified oocysts. Generally, he discovered on August 20. So, for his discovery, he got the Nobel Prize in 1902. Okay. So, and on his memory of discovery, August 20 is celebrated as. World Mosquito Day. August 20 is celebrated as what? World Mosquito Day. World Mosquito Day. And April 20, from 2007 it is celebrated. It is being celebrated from 2007. August 20 is World Mosquito Day. Next, if you see April 25th, this is World Malaria Day. So what is the World Malaria Day? April 25th. So August 20 is celebrated as World Mosquito Day. April 25th is celebrated as World Malaria Day. And the entire life cycle in Anopheles. So the sexual life cycle of Plasmodium vivax in female Anopheles. female anopheles was described by the grassy. It was described by the grassy. So grassy described the life cycle of Plasmodium vivax in the female anopheles. So this is about the introduction of Plasmodium vivax.